Hello. My name is Grimtar Sigarin. Hit the bell and let you start. The collapsing of the fishing industries and the fish stocks or populations are starting since 1950. It is easy to see that this world will not sustain themselves. With 7.8 billion marine and land animal eating primates. Now, it can sustain themselves if anybody was vegan, which since it is not the case. Since the 1950s, new technologies for fishing starting to be developed, which allowed fishermen to go into far rarer, bigger areas of the ocean and far deeper into the waters, and with more sufficiency catch larger amount of fish. If we look to the statistics, often studies how research this kind of questions, you see that if you take a statistics that since the 1950s and the 2001, the first year of the 21st century, around the half of the fish populations were declined. Today, only around 10% of the fish is not exploited. This is of a study of the FAO, State of the Ocean Report 2014. That means that only 10% is not exploited, and that means that around 80% of the oceans are in some kind of exploitation since 2014. In the 1950s, also the populations of phytoplankton are starting to decline, with today only remaining around 50% of the phytoplankton populations of the were in the 50s. This is also because as we have decimated around 90% of all the cetaceans, whales, dolphins from the oceans since in the 20th century for nuclear weapons, because the whale oil in the head of the whale is largely used in machinery because it is highly heat resistant, and it is therefore used in the production of nuclear bombs. So I was thinking, so people have killed one of the most important sea creatures for the environment and steal their oil to build weapons of mass destruction? And we claim we are intelligent? Think about it. But furthermore, in the 1960s, fisher slave traders developed more efficient, meaning more destructive, methods of catching larger amounts of fish with more stronger and powerful trawlers, along with radars and electric navigation systems and sonars, preserving the fish slave traders to terrorize the fish population with unparalleled success in terror. Canadian fish catch peaked by the end of the 70s and the early 80s. The new technologies affected in one very bad way the Nordic cod population in two significant terrifying ways. First, the first way of terrorizing the endangerment of the populations of the cod was because of that the new technologies helped to fish larger areas and their deep and in larger amount until the surviving fish cannot replenish themselves anymore. Second, the trawlers have a large amount of bycatch, and with the cut, also significant amount of economical, not so much important, but ecological, a very important fish as a bycatch. With the Nordic cod, there are also a significant amount of kabeljauw, a very important prey species of the Nordic cod population. Furthermore, because of this, the transatlantic Nordic cod fisheries collapsed around the day of my birth, 1992. All industrialized fishing methods come with an extremely high amount of bycatch, with one study estimated only the amount of fish as bycatch in the Pacific Ocean by longliners. Longliners are large nets that drift in the ocean with a length of around 100 kilometers. The study found that around 4.4 million non-targeted marine animals were captured in this nets, with around some 3.3 million sharks, around 58,000 turtles, 77,000 albatrosses, around 20,000 dolphins and whales, and around 1 million marlins. Around 650,000 marine mammals, included whales, dolphins and seals, are killed any year by marine vessels, fishing ships. Because of this, almost all fish products sold inside the United States are in violation of their own federal law, namely the Marine Mammal Protection Act, which is pitifully, or must I say, despicably not enforced for at least 40 years. With around 80% of all fish eaten in the United States coming from foreign sources, this means that the American fish industry have a large hand in the decimation of marine mammal populations, along with the violation of their own federal laws. It is estimated by my friends, other marine mammal scientists, that we can have empty oceans in the year 2048. Furthermore, what about fish farms then? Fish farms, aquaculture, started and took off around the 1950s. Fish farms actually increase the amount of that is scattered out of the ocean. Why? First, fish farms modify marine animal habitats. Furthermore, the marine animals most people eat are predatory fish. That means large amount of fish have to go to these fish farms, which are the majority of the fish catched by fish slave vessels are being fed to fish salmon farms, caballeran farms, along with pigs, chickens and cows. Now, about speaking for your lifestyle to others, you're forcing actually cows to be carnivores or omnivores, along with that people are feeding bones of cows that they are ground up into the food, so you make them carnivores or omnivores, plus you make them cannibals. So ironically, from the 1950s onwards to the 2001, fish farms increased with around 38%, with around 1 million up to around 38 million. tons. The US feeds any year more than 5.6 billion tons wild marine animals to the animals they eat, with between 144 and 280 sea animals killed annually to feed the enslaved fish like shrimp and salmon around the world, consumed by the average American or Western or Eastern carnist. Keep in mind, so I have said before, around since the 1950s to the early 2012, fish populations decline with around 50%, where the amount of fish catched increased significantly. Like my hero Captain Paul Watson always say, we will not live here with an empty ocean. When the seas die, we die. Furthermore, this is absolutely true. Since around 70% of all the oxygen come from phytoplankton, the microorganisms we are killing by decimating the ocean's environment and symbiotic relationships, it is very much a fact that we will not live here with an empty ocean. Peace begins on the dinner table by a vegan meal. And until that dumb day comes, I will let you look like dumb as a fuck. Because you don't deserve any respect when you are not being respectful to other living beings.